Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of watercolor and pastel mixed media drawings from photos. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. I provided a link to a custom brush set we'll be using later that you could download. The link is in my video's description or project files. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, its resolution should be 72 pixels per inch. To check it, go to Image and Image Size. If it isn't 72 pixels, once you type it in, you'll notice that the width and height changed as well. Feel free to increase its width and height if you want. Unlock the background and temporarily hide it. We'll make a new layer under it by Control or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill it with 50% gray. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard or go to Edit and Fill. Click 50% gray. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Rough Pastels. The texture is canvas, the stroke length is 40, and the stroke detail is 1. The scaling is 200, the relief is 50, and the light is bottom. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. In the Input Highlight field, type in 136, which brightens the gray base to white while retaining the texture. Shift-click the bottom layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command-G to place them into a folder. Let's name it Paper Base. Make your photo visible and active. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Click the plus icon at the lower right, which adds an additional Rough Pastels filter. We'll replace it with Paint Daubs. Make the brush size 6 and the sharpness 20. Presently, the Paint Daub filter is affecting the Rough Pastels filter, however, we want the filters reversed. Drag Paint Daubs under Rough Pastels. Now, the Rough Pastels filter is affecting Paint Daubs. Convert it into a smart object. We'll make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change its blend mode to luminosity. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Artistic folder and open the Texture folder. Click Texturizer. The texture is canvas. The scaling is 200%, the relief is 4, and the light is from the top. Hide Paint Daubs and click OK. Open the Adjustments panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Adjustments. Click the Vibrance icon. Drag the Vibrance all the way to the right, and for the Saturation, I'll type in 40. You may want to adjust the amount of saturation for your image depending on the color intensity you want. The main difference between vibrance and saturation is this. Vibrance only affects the less saturated colors, while saturation boosts the intensity of all the colors in a photo. Click the Adjustments panel again and click the Photo Filter icon. These filters essentially give our image a color cast. If your image is too warm, as in this example, I'll cool it down by clicking any one of the cooling filters. Conversely, if your image is too cool, you can warm it up by clicking a warming filter. I'll pick Cooling Filter 80. We can also increase or decrease its density or intensity. Shift-click the bottom image to make it active as well, and group them into a folder. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. In this layer mask, we'll brush in a custom brush around its inside perimeter, which will mask out our image, thereby revealing the paper base under it. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Scroll to the bottom and open the Colored Pencil Textures folder. I'll pick Colored Pencil 4, but feel free to try the others as well. I'll make its size 175 pixels. Its opacity and flow are both 100%. Open the Brush Settings panel by pressing the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. Click Shape Dynamics. All the controls are off, and the size jitter and roundness jitter are both 0%. Make the angle jitter 20%. Then close the panel. Brush around the inside perimeter to reveal the paper base. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.